out again. Let's get
Hey, what's up guys, it's Darius, and I've had iPhone SE for about 3 months now, and this is my review. iPhone SE is a very interesting product that only Apple could make. On the one hand, it is very underwhelming, boring even. I mean, you get the exact same hardware as iPhone 8. On the other hand, in some aspects, it completely blows the competition out of the water, and I'll get to what I mean later. Personally, I did not expect to like iPhone SE, but to my surprise, I really do. It just has something about it that makes the user experience pleasant. Obviously, this is the small and affordable iPhone. Externally, it is the exact same as iPhone 8. Literally everything except for the now centered Apple logo. I think from the backside, it still looks quite good, and this candy red looks excellent. The front, however, is straight out of 2015. Remember, the iPhone's design has not drastically changed since the iPhone 6. The same old recycled design doesn't necessarily make it bad though. It is still a very premium device. But no one is going to know that you have the newest iPhone, which means no flexing, and I think that's intentional by Apple. It is built really well and will last you a long time. In the 3 months, I've dropped mine quite a few times, and there are no cracks or major scratches on it. There are, however, a lot of smaller scratches that are harder to see, and I think it's because it doesn't use the tougher glass that Apple uses in the iPhone 11 Pro. Additionally, it also has an IP67 water and dust resistance, which is nice. Taking a look around the device, there's obviously no headphone jack nor expandable storage, but it does support dual SIM via an eSIM. The buttons are very nice and clicky, and I really like having a mute switch, but that's obviously not exclusive to the iPhone SE. The stereo speakers are also excellent. They sound very rich and full and don't distort at high volumes. Personally, the biggest adjustment I had to make when switching to the iPhone SE was adjusting to the small display. Sure, iPhone SE is small, but the display is tiny, and that is because of the very low screen-to-body ratio with bezels straight out of 2015. The display is without a doubt the SE's weakness. It's not actually terrible, it gets very bright, and resolution is not a big issue because the screen is so small. Nevertheless, it can't measure up to its competition, even in its price segment. I know that someone with an old iPhone switching to this might not really care, but do note that in a few years, this thing will look absolutely ancient. Having these big bezels means there is room for Touch ID, and just Touch ID, no additional Face ID. It is quite fast and decently reliable, but I found it quite annoying if you have smudges on it or on your finger. It didn't work that often, and I think Face ID is more reliable. A benefit in today's day and age, though, is that it works while wearing a mask. Let's quickly talk about software and performance, and this is an area where the iPhone SE completely excels, especially compared to its competition at its price point. Performance is incredible thanks to its A13 chip, which is the exact same processor found in the $1,000 iPhone 11 Pro. It flies through iOS and never slows down or crashes, no matter what I threw at it. Speaking of iOS, there's no surprises here, you get what you expect. It is still a little limited for my taste, but it does come with a bunch of features like iMessage, AirPlay, AirDrop, and Apple Pay. In the 3 months, there have been quite a few updates, mainly to fix a few bugs, and it's currently running iOS 13.6. It will get iOS 14 in the fall and many more updates for years to come. The update support Apple provides is amazing. The iPhone 6s from 2015 will even get the update to iOS 14, and that's just amazing. Could you imagine a Galaxy S6 running Android 10? When I heard that iPhone SE will even have the exact same camera sensor as iPhone 8, I was a little disappointed. Sure, it was quite capable, but it's also 2.5 years old now. The results this little guy produced really surprised me though. The improved image processing works wonders. In good lighting, it can actually be hard to tell the difference between it and the iPhone 11, which is really impressive. In low light, however, it sadly falls apart because despite having the exact same processor as the higher end iPhones, it sadly lacks the very capable night mode. Lastly, the battery. It's alright, but it's not great. I got about 4 to 4.5 hours of screen on time, and it did get me through a regular day, but if I did end up using it a little more, I had to charge it in the evening. I definitely wouldn't mind having a bigger battery and the iPhone just being a little thicker. It supports the not particularly fast charging via the Lightning port, fast chargers sold separately, as well as wireless charging. To conclude, iPhone SE is an amazing smartphone with a great value, but it's not for everyone. At its price point, you probably get the best camera quality, best performance, and best speakers. You also get a premium build with water resistance and update support for years to come. On the other hand, you get an old design with big bezels, a small, mediocre screen, battery life is not very good, and the camera lacks a night mode. In my opinion, it is absolutely worth the price though. It is your best option if you want a sub $500 to $600 iPhone or just a small iPhone. But do note that the upcoming iPhone 12 is rumored to be very small as well. I'm sure it won't be cheaper than the iPhone SE, but it might actually be smaller. So if you're looking for a small iPhone, maybe wait for that. In terms of price, good Android alternatives are the Galaxy A51 and A71 and the brand new OnePlus Nord. In terms of small form factors, there aren't many options. Maybe a Pixel 4 or the Xperia 10 Mark II, but like I said, there aren't really many options. If you're looking to pick up the iPhone SE or any of the alternatives I mentioned, there will be links to the most up-to-date prices and the best deals in the description below. Thank you guys for watching. I really hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to smash the like button, click here to subscribe, and hit the notification bell to not miss any of my upcoming videos, for example, on the new OnePlus Nord, and click here to see my other videos. See you in the next one. Bye.